Welcome back to Patriot Field. It's time now for our 5 Points Bank starting lineups. 5 Points Bank, now with three locations in Hastings to serve you more than any other bank in town. North at 2815 Osborne Drive, south at 320 South Burlington, and downtown at 322 North St. Joe. 5 Points Bank, the better bank. Well, when we take a look at the Adams Central Patriots, take a look at that defense. It has been outstanding. Andrew Eberhardt, 235-pound junior, will be at one defensive end. Adam Drudik, 225-pound senior, will be the other defensive end. The leading tackler is Jordan Ruger, one defensive tackle, 225 and a senior. Jeremy Court, 235 and a senior, is the other defensive tackle. Alex Niederklein will start tonight at an outside linebacker spot, 175 and a senior. He's not 100%. If he can't go the distance, Kevin Linneman, who's had a pretty good set in his place, will be in there. The other outside linebacker, Forrest Whiteman, 160-pound junior. James Nervick and Mackenzie MG will be the inside linebackers. MG, again, not 100% himself, and Linneman will be in there for him if need be. The defensive back, Evan Volsky, 175-pound senior, and Brett Poppy, 175-pound senior, and Kevin Turway will roam center field, 165-pound junior. Those are the defensive starters for the Adams Central Patriots. We'll take right after this for 5 Points Bank.
Banking is just more rewarding when you choose 5 Points Bank. 5 Points Bank is locally owned, meaning you get local decisions without waiting on distant corporate headquarters. 5 Points Bank of Hastings has three local branches to serve you, more than any other bank in Hastings. North at 2815 Osborne Drive West, south at 320 South Burlington, and downtown at 322 West St. Joseph. And you have the satisfaction of knowing your bank is a real part of the community, involved with youth sports activities, helping with charities, and sponsoring community events. Discover the rewards of better banking at the Better Bank. 5 Points Bank. Member FDIC.
Well, for the Wood River Eagles, Adam Anderson will be the tight end, 6'3", 180 and a senior. The split end, Sam Boschert, 6'1", 170 and a senior. Down lineman at left tackle, Danny Gill, 6'2", 250 and a junior. The right tackle is Kyle Swanson, 6'2", 270 and a senior. The left guard is Adam Thompson, 6'1", 185 and a senior. And Zach Devil will be the right guard, 5'10", 163 and a junior. The center is Alex Eager, 5'11", 190 and a junior. The wingback, Zach Eager, 6'1", 165 and a senior. The quarterback for the Eagles, Jake Wissing, 6'1", 165 and a junior. The fullback is Tyler Schultz, 5'9", 165 and a junior. And the I-back is Jeff Harders, 5'8", 155 and a senior. Those are your 5 Points Bank starting lineups for tonight. 5 Points Bank, now with three locations to serve you more than any other bank in Hastings. North at 2815 Osborne Drive, south at 320 South Burlington, and downtown at 322 North St. Joe. 5 Points Bank, the better bank. And now we'll be back with the kickoff in just a moment.
At State Farm, good neighbor service is a proud tradition. State Farm agent Doug Bolliger at 2632 West 2nd Street in Hastings has been a part of that heritage for 25 years. Year after year, people like you come to State Farm agent Doug Bolliger for affordable insurance, but they stay for the good neighbor service. Trust State Farm agent Doug Bolliger with all your insurance needs. Whether it's car, home, life, health, or business insurance, you'll always get the good neighbor service State Farm and State Farm agent Doug Bolliger have made famous.
That first freeze of winter is closer than you think. Get peace of mind and prevent problems next spring with a professional winterization from Buzz's Marine. Buzz's factory-trained technicians will winterize your boat using only Mercury Marine components, plus Buzz's will refill your engine with the best biodegradable antifreeze to assure your boat is ready for winter. And if you're thinking of trading, Buzz's has some great end-of-season deals right now. Head to Buzz's Marine, your Mercury dealer, 5th and Central Kearney.
Have sore, tired feet? Isn't it time you tried a pair of SAS shoes from Brown Shoe Fit in downtown Hastings? If you already own a pair of SAS shoes, then you know how wonderful your feet feel in America's favorite comfort shoes. And now through October 8th, save $12 on all regular priced SAS shoes. And Brown's is stocked with hundreds of pairs for men and women in timeless styles. If they don't have it in stock, they'll order it for you in the size and width to fit you. Make your feet happy during the SAS sale going on now at Brown Shoe Fit Company in downtown Hastings.
KLIQ Hastings, The Breeze, 94.5.
Well, we welcome you back to Patriot Field on homecoming here at Adams Central High School. And the Wood River Eagles will kick it away to get this first quarter started. Adams Central dropping back deep to receive on the far side, Kevin Turway. On the near side, Evan Volsky. As we view them here from the 50-yard line, the Patriots will be moving left to right as they cross your radio dial. And we're set for football here on a Friday night on the Breeze 94.5. Kicking it away, Zach Hager. And we are underway. The kick is high and going to be headed toward Turway at the goal line. In fact, about 3 yards deep, and he will down it. It'll come out to the 20-yard line. So the Patriots will start at their own. Their offense looks like this. Scott Carlin, 108-pound senior quarterback. He's a 52% passer. He's thrown 4 TDs, 2 interceptions, and thrown for 274 yards this season. Forrest Wakeman, 160-pound junior, will be the up back in the Maryland eye. James Nervick, 180-pound junior, will be in the middle. And Kevin Turway, who took over at halftime in Cozad and has rushed for better than 500 yards the first four games, will be the tailback. They break out of it. Pitch goes to the deep back in the backfield, Alex Niederklein. Niederklein looking for a place to go. So Niederklein gets the start instead of Turway tonight. And Niederklein bounced it over the right side of his offensive line and picked up about a yard or two. So Alex Niederklein coming back off of the injured ankle. He's been in the lineup the last week or so, but hasn't played a lot. Gets the call tonight. He is at tailback. Slot right formation coming out wide to the right side is Brett Poppe, nearest us. Movement defensively, handoff to Niederklein, bounces it wide to the left. If he gets to the outside, he's got some room. He picks up about 5 yards to the 27-yard line. Turned upside down on the far side by outside linebacker Alex Eager. But Niederklein moves it out to the 27-yard line for a gain of 5, and it'll be third down and 3 yards to go. The tight end for the Patriots, Adam Drudik. Evan Volsky and Poppy will split at wide receiver. We'll get to down 5 in just a moment. As Carlin has him to the line of scrimmage, power eye formation in the backfield. They hand off to Niederklein again. Comes wide to the right side. Looks for the corner. He's got the first down. Ridden out of bounds, out near the 35-yard line. Hanging on, riding to the sideline and taking him out of bounds was Tyler Lucas, one of the defensive backs. But the gain was good to the 36, maybe the 37-yard line, a gain of about 10 for Alex Niederklein. And it's first down and 10 for the Adams Central Patriots. Jeremy Court and Andrew Eberhardt are the tackles offensively. Chad Doherty into the ball game for Hemji tonight at one guard, along with Brett Owen. Movement on the left side of the offensive line, and that'll cost the Patriots 5. The center, Brandon Meyer. Defensively for Wood River, Danny Powell and Adam Anderson are the defensive ends. The defensive tackles, Adam Anderson and Danny Gills. The linebackers, Jared Munson, Tyler Schultz, and Alex Eager. The defensive backfield, Jeff Harters, Zach Eager. Tyler Lucas will be in and out of there. Sam Bolshert and Jake Wissing round out the defensive unit. So with 10:41 left to play here in the first quarter, no score. It will be first down and 15 yards to go for a first down for the Adams Central Patriots in their own territory. Hand off to the middle back. And Nervig bounces to the right side, and he's got a wide open field. He's in the 45-50 and down into Wood River territory. Rolled out of bounds. Down around the 45-yard line by Danny Powell, the defensive end who came chasing.
Ball goes at about the 43-yard line. It'll be Patriots ball, first down.
Well, they'll put the ball down at the 41-yard line. ...27 yards for James Nervig. And the Patriots, Nervig wanted to go up the middle. Now back to the conventional Maryland eye. And we get movement in the backfield as Forrest Wakeman, the up back, started too soon. That'll be another 5-yard penalty for the Patriots, and that will take them back out to the 47-yard line. And it'll be first down and 15 once again. 10.5 minutes to play here in the first quarter. First drive of the ball game. The Patriots have an opening kickoff at their own 20-yard line. Now have it in Wood River territory at the 47. First down and 15 yards to go. Both ends in tight. All three backs stacked in the eye. The handoff to Niederklein. Niederklein hit in the backfield. Pulls out of the tackle. He'll get across the 45 and down to about the 43-yard line. in the backfield was defensive end Danny Powell. He slowed him down, and then Jeff Harder's made to the stop. It's a gain of 4 yards for Niederklein, and will bring up second down and 11 from the 42, 43-yard line. Tell you what, Danny Powell had that one snuffed out, the 6'4 senior. Now the Patriots split Poppy out wide to the left side, back wing left formation, Carlin to throw into the flat. It's hauled in at about the 35-yard line, taken by Forrest Whiteman, the up back, and Whiteman is slammed to the ground at the 32. It'll be a gain of about 9 yards, and Harder's again on the tackle. So third down and 2 yards to go as they picked up nine on the play to Forrest Whiteman out of the backfield. The Patriots with a third down and short go back to the tight formation. Both ends in tight, back stacked in the Maryland eye. Carlin with the call. Handoff goes over the right side, and Turway is wrestled to the ground by Tyler Schultz, the middle linebacker, right at the 30-yard line. They'll back it up to the 31, and it's going to be close. It is enough for a first down. So Turway, seeing his first action, picks up two and gets the first down to move the sticks. Well, Niederklein basing on the sideline. 21 yards on four carries. Turway in a tailback now. As we mentioned, he's over 500 yards on the season. Under two carries, 511 yards, and he gets the call here. They swing him wide to the right, cuts him behind the block, and from behind, he's ridden to the ground by Jared Monson, one of the three linebackers, but not before. He picks up about 5 yards, just angling across the right side, going off the hip of his right tackle, Andrew Eberhardt. They'll give him 7 yards on the carry, and it'll be second down and 3 yards to go as the football down to the 23-yard line. They need to take it down to the 20 for a first down. Same formation, both ends in tight. Olski on the right side, Drudik on the left side away from us. Hand off to Turway again. Gets outside, breaks the tackle behind the line of scrimmage, and then is rolled up the 20-yard line. Turway stopped on the outside by Adam Anderson, the defensive end, but not before he gains about 3 yards, and that'll be enough for a first down. First down and 10 from the 20 as the Patriots, with 8:18 left to play here in the first quarter, opening drive of the ball game. They've had it for nearly 4 minutes. And they come back with a tight formation. Ball at the 20-yard line. They fake left, come right with Turway. Turway slips inside a tackler and then is taken down after a 6 or 7 yard gain. Down inside the 15, the tackle made by Sam Boschert, one of the defensive backs. It's a gain of 6 for Kevin Turway. They tried to influence the defense by that little counter back to the right side, a little jab step to the left to come back to the right. Turway picks up, let's call it 5 yards, 6 yards to go. It's a long 4 yards for the first down. Again, double tights, Maryland eye, handoff to Turway. He's hit in the backfield and dropped at the line of scrimmage. Knifing through there was defensive tackle Adam Thompson. And it's a loss of a couple of yards. It'll be third down and 5 yards to go for a first down. Seven minutes left to play. First quarter, no score here at Patriot Field on homecoming. Third down and 5 for Carlin. Tight formation, jumping defensively. Hand off to Turway right up the middle. He just lowers his head and pulls his way for the first down. Takes it down to the 10-yard line and inside the 10. Wrestled to the ground by Jared Monson, one of the three linebackers. That should be enough for the first down. It's a gain of about 6 yards, and it'll be first down and goal from the 9. So the Patriots chewing up yardage, chewing up time on the clock. Volpe brings the play into Scott Carlin, and Carlin huddles the Patriots up. Patriots in their home blue jerseys, gray trousers with white piping, and, of course, their blue helmets with the Patriot logo. First down and goal, Patriots. Handoff goes to Turway, and he's hit in the backfield and dropped back outside the 10-yard line. Jared Monson again. Loss is going to be all the way back to the 15 or 14-yard line, a loss of five. Second down and goal from just inside the 15. Now Poppy comes in from the far sideline, Brett Poppy, 175-pound senior. He and Volsky are the messenger service for Coach Bill Carlin. And on second down and long, Poppy splits out wide to the left side. Goes out as a flanker. Weichmann, wing right, goes in motion back to the left side. Pitch goes to Turway. He's got blockers, cuts it inside. They clamp on him at the 10. He pulls tacklers down to the 7. Finally stopped by Sam Boschert, one of the defensive backs again. So from the 15, the football, or from the 14, down to about the 7-yard line, a gain of 7. So it'll be third down and goal to go. Two tight ends. The Maryland I formation for Scott Carlin. He fakes the handoff, drops back to throw, now steps up in the pocket. He's going to be sacked back outside to the 10 to about the 12-yard line by defensive end Adam Anderson. Wood River's Adam Anderson drops him back out near the 13-yard line. It's a loss of 6 yards for Scott Carlin. And that will bring up a fourth down and goal from the 13. And on fourth down and goal, Weichmann wing right. Turway splits out wide to the left. One back in the backfield. Nervig with Carlin. Carlin to throw for it. Slides right, pumps once, goes long toward the corner, and it's overthrown. And Carlin took a hit as he threw the football. So the long, time-consuming drive for the Patriots comes up empty, and they turn it over on down and turn things over to that staunch defense. 4:28 left to play here in the opening period. And the Wood River Eagles will start out at their own 13, deep in their own territory. They start with motion. Wissing gives the handoff to his deep back in the backfield and spinning for a yard or two is Jeff Harters. Harters stopped by the left side of that defensive line for the Patriots. Jordan Ruger, what a story. Defensive tackle, 25. He leads the 25 tackles. He leads the club in that category. 5 tackles for loss. He leads the club in that category. 2 sacks. He leads the club in that category. And he's also got a fumble recovery. This time, option to the near side. Pitch goes deep. And coming to the left side is Harters again. He is rolled up after a 3 or 4 yard gain. Poppy and Niederklein were out there to make the stop for the Patriots. Well, that option took the football out to the 20-yard line. It'll be third down and about 3 yards to go, a 6-yard gain for Harters. They put the wing back, Zach Ager, out wide to the right side. Option goes that way. They fake the handoff to the fullback, and this time Wissing is buried for a yard or two lost by Adam Niederklein. Or Alex Niederklein, excuse me. Alex Niederklein made the tackle. And it's a loss of a couple of yards. Fourth down and 6, the punting unit comes on. Zach Ager will handle the kicking chores. Ager averages about 30 yards per punt, a little better than that. Turway and Volsky back deep at midfield to receive. Good snap, good high kick, angles it to the far side of the field. It is going to be out of bounds, and they will walk that one back down to about the 40-yard line. 42 is where it'll be. So the Patriots do not give up a first down and get the football back. They will take over with 2:45 left to play here in the first quarter. No score in the ball game, and they will start at the Wood River 42-yard line. This has been a trademark of this ball club this season, field position. It has been huge. It was huge in the opener against Cozad. They had it in Haymaker territory all night, and it's been pretty much the same story off and on throughout the entire season. Handoff goes right up the middle to James Nervig, and Nervig gets it across the 40 and down to about the 37 before he is turned back. Jared Munson, the linebacker, in on another one. He has been in on a bunch tonight. 3 yard gain for Nervig. Now Poppy in the ball game as a receiver, comes wide to the right side nearest us. Nervig flanks out wide to the left side. Carlin calls the play to his receivers now and barks out the signal. Hand off to Niederklein. Niederklein bounces to the left. He gets down inside of the 35 before he is pushed out of bounds on the far side of the field. Whole host of jerseys over there, but they were led by linebacker Jared Munson once again. It'll be third down and a long 3 yards to go for a first down. 4 yard pickup for Niederklein. He's got 25 yards on the night on 5 carries so far. Well, the Patriots spread it out once again. Flanker right, split left, handoff to Niederklein, trying to go right, and he is dropped in the backfield. Coming through, middle linebacker Tyler Schultz, and Schultz ate him up back at about the 36-yard line. So it will be a loss of 2 yards for Alex Niederklein and bring up another fourth down call for the Patriots. Fourth down and about 4 yards to go, and they will punt it away this time. Scott Carlin back to punt. Carlin, end over end. It's going to hit at about the 15, bounce to the 10, roll inside the 5, and go into the end zone. So it will come out to the 20-yard line as the Patriots have to punt it away. So that long time-consuming drive in the first period, Patriots come up empty, three and out on their second possession. Wood River at their own 20 with just a minute and a half left to play here in the first quarter. No score in the football game. Hager splits out wide to the left side nearest us. Back stacked in the eye behind Wissing. Hand off, fake to the fullback. Wissing turns it to the left side, gets a block, gets out to the 25 to the 30 and out to about the 31-yard line. Rocked there by Brett Poppy among others, but it's going to be a pickup of about 11 yards and a first down in the ball game for the Eagles. 11 yards and a first down and 10 at the 31-yard line. This time, Sam Bolscher goes out wide to the right side. All in the ball game now, Tyler Lucas, and he's in the slot on the right side. Handoff, they try the right side, carrying the football for a little gain is Jeff Harders. Harders hit by Mackenzie Hemji. And also in on the play, Jordan Ruger. It's a gain of a part of a yard for Harders. It'll be second down and 9 yards to go. It'll be a long nine, though. Second down, and the quarter coming to a close in a hurry. 40 seconds left. Now they get motion back this way by Ager. Pitch goes deep to Harders. Harders try to cut inside. There's nothing there. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about all. And it's Ruger again, plugging the hole and making the stop for the Adams Central Patriots. He might have gotten part of the yard. It'll be third down and 9 yards to go for a first down. And they may not pull the trigger again as we're down to the final 14 seconds of the first period. This first quarter is going to come to a close, and when this score resounds throughout the area, it is 0-0. The Wood River Eagles, 0-4, standing toe-to-toe with the Patriots, 4-0. No score in the ballgame after one quarter of play. We'll be back with the second quarter in a minute.
When it comes time to squelch that burning ring of fire in you, head to Murphy's Wagon Wheel in Hastings. At Murphy's, they keep their barbecue pit hot until 11 p.m. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Stop in and enjoy baby back ribs, smoked half chicken, and deep barbecue brisket slow cooked on their all-new full pit barbecue. All this and Murphy's Wagon Wheel continues to have their great nightly specials too. Perfect for after the game or anytime. So what you waiting for? Meet you at the wheel in downtown Hastings.
Ring of fire.
The Breeze, 94.5.
It is third down and 9 for Wood River. As They move from their own 32-yard line, 31-yard line. Wissing rolls right, going to put it in the air for the first time, and throws it out to the near sideline, just threw it away. He knew his time was running out, and he just threw it into his own bench. That's the first pass attempt for Jake Wissing tonight. So fourth down, and the punting unit comes on. Patriots had 81 yards of offense in that first period. The Eagles, 17. Patriots dominated the clock with that opening drive. That ended up using 7 minutes and 32 seconds, but they came away empty. So Wood River to punt it away again. Good high kick. Turway angles to the right. He'll let it bounce at about the 43. Takes a right-handed hop and goes out of bounds right there. 43-yard line. So the Eagles, one first down in the ball game, 17 yards of offense, and the Patriots take over at their own 43-yard line. Second quarter just getting a good start, 11 minutes and 14 seconds left to go. See if they open it up a little bit. The Eagles have really been jamming the line of scrimmage with a lot of movement. Carlin back to throw. He'll let it go. It is overthrown just barely. It was intended for Forrest Wakeman out of the backfield, and it was just a shade too tall for it. Carlin now 1 out of 3 for 9 yards in the ballgame. It is second down and 10 from their own 43-yard line for the Patriots. Well, Adams Central now with Poppy splitting out wide to the right side. That's the short side of the field away from us. Here in the second quarter, the Patriots moving right to left. Wakeman comes out wide this way as a flanker. The pitch goes deep in the backfield. Kevin Turway, Alex Niederklein. Niederklein weaves through traffic across midfield and down to the Wood River 45 before he's finally slammed out of bounds at about the 43-yard line of the Eagles. On the play again, Jared Munson. He has been in on a bunch of tackles in this one. 14-yard pickup for Alex Niederklein. Niederklein, 37 yards in the ball game on 7 carries so far. Wakeman again, the flanker, goes wide to the right side away from us. Two setbacks in the backfield. Niederklein again across the right side of his offensive line. Busts a couple of tackles. Keeps his feet. Breaks another one. Gets down to the 30-yard line. 13-yard pickup for Alex Niederklein and another first down for the Patriots. The Patriots have come out with a purpose in this drive right here. An offensive line starting to take charge. 10.5 minutes to play here in the second quarter. No score in the ball game. Again, flanker formation, two backs in the backfield for Carlin. And they go to Niederklein again across the right side, gets to the corner. He'll have another 5 or 6 yards, driven out of bounds on the far side of the field by Tyler Lucas. And we also have a flag down right at the 25-yard line.
Flag on the play.
Holding against the Adams Central Patriots at 25. Well, that will cost the Patriots a little bit. The gain was good for about 7 or 8 yards, but Niederklein will only get 5 of it, and then there will be a 10-yard walk-off. As the football now pushed back out to the 35-yard line. First down at about 15, maybe 16 yards to go for a first down. Just over 10 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Again, flanker to the left side, Wakeman out there. Poppy splits wide right, little screen to the right side to Poppy. Poppy gets it, picks up 5 yards. He's grabbed by Tyler Lucas, and Lucas stands him up and holds him up until he gets some help. And the 5-yard gain will stand for the Patriots, maybe even 6 on the play. So Brett Poppy with the catch, his 4th reception of the year. This one good for 6 yards, and it will be Second down and 9 yards to go for a first down. The Patriots at the 29-yard line of Wood River. The Eagles movement inside. Short drop. Quick flare out to the left side to Poppy again. And again, Lucas hangs on until he gets some help. It's a gain of a couple three. Tyler Lucas hanging on, and then Sam Bushard came over to make the stop permanent. It's a gain of about 3 yards on the play. Poppy back-to-back receptions. They just go down the line of scrimmage and try and break him loose. We move past the 9-minute mark here in the second quarter. No score in the football game as the Patriots driving once again. It is third down and 7 yards to go from about to the 27-yard line. Carlin with the call for the Patriots. Rolls right to throw. Sets up now. Little out to the far side. Incomplete. Intended for Alex Niederklein. Niederklein, the intended receiver. They just kind of swung him around the right tackle straight up the field and then broke him off to the outside. The pass was a little long. It'll be fourth down and 7. For Adams Central. Fourth down and 7. They do not even think about anything but a first down. Poppy splits out wide to the right side. Forrest Weichmann in the slot on the right side as well. Carlin back to throw, has time, looks up the left side, and out there wide open is Weichmann, and he's gone for the touchdown.
Pass is complete.
Forrest Weichmann coming across. He got outside the hash mark, and Carlin just drilled it. A 27-yard score. Weichmann with his second catch of the night. We have our first touchdown of the ball game. First score comes at the 8:40 mark here in the second quarter. And the Patriots will go for two. They have not gone for a single-point conversion at all this year. They go back to the tight formation. Drudy getting tight on the right side. Volsky and tight on the left side. Three back stacked in the eye. Fumble on the snap. Carlin picks it up. Gives it to Turway. Turway fumbles it, and then Turway recovers it again. And that will stuff out the extra point attempt, and the Patriots will lead it 6-0 with 8:40 left to play here in the first half. We'll be back with the Patriot kickoff in just a moment.
It's been well over 60 years since Kerr Chevrolet of Hastings sold their first Chevrolet. You know, they probably sold your granddad his first car or truck. And Kerr Chevrolet probably sold your dad his first Chevy. There's a reason why they've been in business for over 60 years and why generation after generation keeps coming back. And today, Kerr Chevrolet is better than ever. With Chevrolet's new generation of cars and trucks and Kerr's better service with Mr. Goodrich trained mechanics and most of all, better pricing. Fair, honest, and always getting better. Even now, that's Kerr Chevrolet, 800 South Burke.
Well, the Patriots get on the scoreboard. They end up with a 57-yard drive covering eight plays, about 2.5 minutes off the clock, and they lead it by a score of 6-0 now on the pass play from Scott Carlin to Forrest Weichmann. Carlin? That was his fifth touchdown pass of the year. 8:40 left to go, and the Patriots kick it away. Pulled in back deep by Jack Withy. Withy turns it up, comes to the right side, and sprints out to the 31-yard line, maybe the 32. They'll put it down at the 31-yard line. Special teams. Junior Sean Hatchell, not a big guy, but he made the stop, 134-pounder. With 8.5 minutes to play here in the first half, Wood River goes slot right with Boschert out wide, Eager in the slot. Whistling the call, back staggered behind him. Whistling, rolls right, throws on the run and completes it to his fullback, Kyler Schultz. And Schultz will pick up about 3 yards, maybe four. Ridden out of bounds by Turway and Niederklein. Well, Schultz gains about three, takes the football out to the 34-yard line. First completion of the ball game for Jake Withing. This time they swing it out to the left side. Harder fumbles the football, and the Patriots have it. Guess who? Jordan Ruger with his second fumble recovery of the season. It's a loss of a couple of yards on. And with the recovery for the Patriots, now the Patriots standing at point blank range here in the second quarter. They start at the 30-yard line of Wood River. 8:22 left to go here in the second quarter. Handoff goes to Turway. Turway across the right side, and Turway gets to the outside, gets down inside the 20, and runs out of real estate. Gets out of, steps on the sideline down around the 16-yard line. So it's a game of 14 or 15, depending on the spot of the football. Those are the football just short of the 15-yard line. So Turway now with 40 yards on the night on the ground as he runs out of the deep back in the Maryland I formation. Three back stacked again. Turway again, right side. Irving gets a block on the corner. The Eagles grab it, hang on, and Turway takes it down to about the 6-yard line, a gain of 9 more. First to hit him was Zach Igger, one of the defensive backs on that left side, and he just sort of hung on until he got some help. It'll be second down and about a yard to go as Turway rips off another 9 yards. The football down at the 7-yard line. Carlin with the call. Gives it to Turway again. Slips the tackle in the backfield. Takes it to the end zone. Touchdown. Kevin Turway from 7 yards out takes it in. And the Patriots here in this drive, 3 plays, 30 yards. And they add to their total. They lead it now 12-0 with 8:06 left to play. So in less than a minute, almost less than a half a minute, the Patriots have scored twice. And they come to the line of scrimmage to go for two. Wood River overloads their left side. Now they settle in, and Carlin fumbles the snap once again, and flags come from everywhere. They came from the back offensive backfield. They came from the linesman on the far side. It's a procedure penalty against the Patriots, and that'll take the football back out to the 8-yard line. Their fourth penalty of the night for 25 yards. And this will make the 2-point conversion a little longer. Two tight end formation. Drudik on the right side. Poppy on the left side nearest us. The three backs in the Maryland eye. Carlin rolls right to throw. Looks to the end zone and delivers. It is incomplete. Broken up in the end zone nicely by Tyler Lucas. So the extra point, no good. The score remains 12-0 in favor of the Patriots. And we'll be back with another Patriot kickoff in just a moment.
Klinger Embroidery Plus. Our name has changed, but not our goals. We continue to be your one-stop shop for corporate apparel. Klinger Embroidery Plus has the latest styles and easy care fabrics. Check out the selection of ladies' apparel with matching styles for men at Klinger's. As always, there's no minimum order. Fill-ins are not a problem. For quality work at competitive prices, Klinger Embroidery Plus, helping your business look outstanding.
The Breeze, 94.5.
Now the Adams Central Patriots tee it up to kick it away with 8:06 left to play. They have taken over here in the second quarter, capitalizing on a fumble and a good sustained drive. So Wood River with Jake Wissing back deep to receive, Wissing back at about his own 5-yard line, awaiting the kickoff. Adam Drudik will kick it away. The Patriots get it airborne. Wissing gathers it in at about the 12, looking for a place to go. No hole there. Cuts it back to the left side, slips the tackle, gets to the outside. Now tries to cut back inside a tackle and takes the football out to the 29-yard line.
Patriot defense was made by Riley Arms. So a good return for Wood River's Jake Wissing, and the Eagles start at their own 29. Well, the Patriots, they've given a little here and there, but they haven't given up much defensively here tonight. Wissing up under center. A little motion in the backfield. Quick handoff to the fullback up across the left side, Tyler Schultz. And Schultz will pick up about 3 yards. Schultz with his first carry of the night. Second down and 7 yards to go for a first down. Football out at the 32-yard line. As they break the huddle and come to the line of scrimmage, Sam Bolscher splits out wide this way. Lucas goes out wide to the left side. Pitch goes deep in the backfield to Harders. Harders running hard to the right side, turns it up, and he just runs into a blue wall. Led by Ruger, Mackenzie Hemge, and Alex Niederklein. The Patriots just closed that one down. It looked like for a moment that the Eagles and Harders had something going on, but it closed in a hurry with those three blue shirts getting there. 2 yard gain for Harders. It'll be third down and a long 5 yards to go for a first down. Bolscher now goes to the wide side of the field away from us this time. And coming this way, Zach Eager for the Wood River Eagles. Wissing, back to throw. Quick hitter up the right side, incomplete. Had his man, couldn't hang on. Out and around the 40-yard line. It was intended for Eggers, and Kevin Turway was closing hard on him, but the pass was incomplete. It'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down and about five and a half yards to go, Turway and Volsky drop back inside their 40 to receive the punt of Zach Eager. Snaps a little low through the hands of Eager. They had the return on. Eager goes back to pick it up. Now he'll have to elude an on-rushing lineman and gets the kick away, and it's not a bad kick after all of that. It'll end up at about the 50-yard line. So I'll tell you what, Eager made something out of nothing right there. The Patriots have done it defensively and now are starting to do it offensively. They have shut the door on the Wood River offense. Ball right at the 50-yard line with 6 minutes. About 6.5 minutes left to go here in the first half. They spread it out a little bit. Take the pitch. Come down the left side. Evans Volsky on the wide receiver screen. And Volsky gets outside down the sideline. They thought he had him out of bounds. They didn't, and he takes it on down the sideline to about the 10 before they do roll him out of bounds. I believe it was Tyler Lucas who finally got him out of bounds. Somebody gave him a shove. I think it was Harders at about the 35-yard, 40-yard line, but he would not go out of bounds, and he kept it going. Down to the 9. A gain of 41 yards for Evan Volsky and Scott Carlin. And it's first down and goal to go. Hand off to Niederklein. Cuts inside a block on the right side. Breaks the tackle to 5. Gets outside. And is in for the touchdown as they unpile everybody. And he's across the goal line for the score. Alex Niederklein going 9 yards. And after having it 2 times and coming away empty in the first period, here in the second quarter, the Patriots have had it 3 times and scored all 3. 9-yard run by Alex Niederklein, 7-yard run by Kevin Turway, and a 27-yard touchdown pass from Scott Carlin to Forrest Wakeman.
And a report.
And the Adams Central Patriots going for 2 again. Hand off to Niederklein, bounces across the right side, pulls out of a tackle, and he's got 2. Alex Niederklein does it again. Well, it is 20-0 now in favor of the Adams Central Patriots with half of the second quarter to go.
We'll be back with the Adams Central kickoff in just a moment.
Think of Krieger Electric when you need residential, commercial, industrial, or farm electrical installation or repair. Think of Krieger Electric for the latest in computer technology, electrical design, and engineering. With their fleet of trucks and years of experience, you can trust Krieger Electric to do the job right. Call Krieger's at 462-5757 for a free estimate on your next electrical project. Krieger Electric, 105 South California in Hastings.
The Breeze, 94.5.
Well, the Patriots that time, 50 yards in two plays. They just used up a mere 28 seconds off the clock. Their last drive covered 16 seconds. And they have opened up the door with a 20-0 lead. And we've got flagged somebody. Somebody jumped the gun to the Patriots. There'll be another penalty for Adams Central. Our score was 0-0 at the end of the first quarter over at Duncan Field tonight. St. Cecilia and Gibbon are scoreless as they play in the second quarter. That score we had, St. Cecilia nothing, Gibbon nothing. The Patriots being offside, and that'll cost them five. Take it back to the 35-yard line. Carlin will tee it up there. Well, Jake Wessing back deep to receive. He'll move out now outside his 15-yard line to haul this one in. As Carlin will kick it away again. This one is airborne, and it's not going to be real deep. It's going to be taken by one of the blockers up front is, would normally have been the wedge. Shane Smith with the return, and Smith gives a pretty good field position out to the 41-yard line. Short kick, they didn't want to give it to Wissing again. And Smith sets the Eagles up in their best field position of the night at their own 41-yard line, first down and 10. Wissing barks out the signal, fakes the handoff, rolls to the left, squares to throw. It is picked off. The tackle was made as the ball got there, and the pass was intercepted by James Nervig. Alex Niederklein made the hit on the fullback. Tyler Schultz, the intended receiver, just as the ball got there. The ball popped in the air, and Nervig intercepts it. They try a little razzle-dazzle, and it's their second turnover of the ball game. And the Adams Central Patriots, again, with the football pretty much at point-blank range. They have the football first down and 10 at the 22-yard line. Hand off to Niederklein, out the right side, gets outside, up the sideline, to the 5, and down to about the 3-yard line. Niederklein picks up about 20 yards on the carry. See where they finally put the football down. It's going to be at about the 3-yard line. So it will be at the 3, first down and goal. They give it to Niederklein again across the right side, and he will go in standing up. 3-yard touchdown run by Alex Niederklein, and Niederklein, who was out with that ankle sprain for a couple of ball games and then kind of eased his way back in, he has come back with a vengeance here tonight. The Patriots, 4 touchdowns in a row, and they lead it 26-0. They bring them all in tight this time, go back to the Maryland eye for the 2-point conversion. Carlin with the call. They'll give it to their horse again. Niederklein right side, and again, he's in easily, untouched, going across that right side behind Owens and Eberhardt over there. And that makes it 28-0 in favor of Adams Central. And we still have 5:44 to play here in the second quarter. It has all come here in the second quarter. The Patriots lead it 28-0. We'll be back in just a moment.
Your eyes here, and I can't believe myself. Are those new chicken strip sandwiches from Runza? Looky there, two juicy, lightly breaded chicken strips made with 100% all white meat chicken. Fresh toppings, gourmet bun. Ooh, I can see this is going to be a big hit.
Introducing Runza's new chicken strip sandwiches, the Spicy Thai, Barbecue, Smothered, and Deluxe. Try one today at Runza. The difference is real.
Got to kick it away. They have 95 yards rushing here in the second quarter alone. And 172 yards altogether in the second period. And Wood River, once again, set for the kickoff. Good high kick. Angle to the near side. Lucas runs back to get it about the 5. Lucas will bring it out to the 10. Out to about the 15-yard line, and he will get it out maybe the 17 or 18 when they all get out of there. Kyle Stein on the stop. Jeremy Hansen was also over there to help out on the tackle for the Patriots and Wood River. First down and 10 at their own 20-yard line. So pretty good return by Tyler Lucas, who had to go back to get it. Again, they kicked it away from Tyler Wissing. Wissing at quarterback. Slides down the left side on the option. Gets the pitch out to the far side, and Harders takes it to the corner, and Harders will pick up about 5 yards. McKenzie Hemge was out there on the play defensively for the Patriots. In the ballgame now and helping out on the stop, Kevin Lenneman. Lenneman has played well, 14 tackles, 11 unassisted, 1 for a loss, 1 sack, and 1 interception in his duty. Lenneman replacing McKenzie Hemge. And Wood River wants a timeout. So with 5:02 to go, it'll be second down for the big lead. And as we come back to you here, handoff goes right up the middle for Wood River.
Bryce Baxter
carrying the football, and Baxter will pick up about 3 yards. Yep. Third down and 4 yards to go with a football at the 26 and a half yard line. Lucas goes out wide to the left side away from us. Receiver wide each side of the field for Wissing. Little out up the near side, nearly picked off. Kevin Turway nearly had it going the other way, and then he got it. He would have had 6. The pass was intended for Sam Boschert, the wide receiver on this side. Wissing on the night, 1 out of 5 with an interception, and that one completion for 3 yards, and it's 4th down and about 3 yards to go, 4 yards to go, excuse me, for a first down. In their own territory, they'll get Eggers in to kick it away. Bolsky and Turway standing at their own 40-yard line for the Patriots, set to receive. High snap, that's over the head of Eggers. Eggers last time had to go between his legs. This time it was high. He gets it, runs it down, gets the kick away. And it's going to take a Wood River bounce and bounce outside their 40 to the 42-yard line. But I tell you what, last two punts have been adventures for Zach Eggers. Eggers saved them both. I mentioned the first one went between his legs. This one here went over his head. Adam Central out to the 42-yard line of Wood River, and this is the fourth drive they started in Wood River territory. 4:10 left to go. The Patriots lead it 28-0. They come out tight, everybody in. The Maryland I formation. The handoff to the deep back end of the I, and it's Kevin Turway in the backfield this time, and Turway eats up 5 or 6 yards, just going right straight up the gut. Out at the bottom of the pile. Again, Jeff Harder is on to the stop. He had some help, Tyler Schultz, among others. So Turway, they give him 6 yards on the rump. He takes it from the 42 down to the 36-yard line. Second down and 4. Turway again. Right side. Bounces outside. He's got to the first down. Right close to it. Again, he's ridden out of bounds by Tyler Lucas in that defensive backfield. It will be a first down
a gain down to the 30, or excuse me, the 29-yard line. 7-yard pickup. And it'll be first down and 10 for the Patriots. Patriots at the Wood River 29. Same formation, they fake the handoff. Carlin to throw, he'll step up in the pocket, breaks a tackle, gets plus yardage out of it, finally taken down as he gets inside the 20 by middle linebacker Tyler Schultz. Carlin, back to throw, didn't get much going, flushed out of the pocket, but it'll be good enough for a first down as the football down to the 18-yard line, a pickup of 10 yards for Scott Carlin. Now the Patriots biting off yardages in big chunks. Hand off to Terway again, and he just blasts right up the middle. He's got another first down. Inside the 5-yard line, it takes three Eagles to get him to the ground. The defensive backfield. Sam Boschert led that charge. He had some help from Harders. Boschert is the leading tackler on the ball club, or one of the leading tacklers. Ball first down and 10 at the Wood River 5-yard line. Scott Carlin with the call again. Hands off Turway. Turway blasts right up the middle. He'll get a couple of 3 yards. Maybe down close to the two. This time the Eagles are waiting on him. Mosher was again in on the stop. Also there was Adam Thompson and a couple of others. So it's a gain of 3. See if they do this, they give it to him again. They just keep running across that right side of that offensive line. Carlin's going to keep it on a quarterback sneak right up the middle, and he's got 2 for the touchdown. So Scott Carlin right up the middle for the 2 yards to cap off the scoring drive, and that's 5 in a row for the Patriots here in the second quarter. And with 2:34 left to play in the first half, Adams Central adds to their lead. They go 42 yards on that drive. Last 2 drives, 2 plays each. This one took a little longer. They set up for the 2-point conversion. Carlin to throw for it, ankles toward the corner, and he's got it out there for the 2-point conversion to Kevin Turway. So the Patriots add 8 more to their total, and it is 36-0 Adams Central with 2:34 left to play here in. Well, the Adams Central Patriots might have got out of the gate a little bit slow in the first quarter. And the fact that they didn't come away with any points, but they have made up for it here in the second quarter. ...137 yards rushing here in the second quarter. Over 200 yards of offense in this quarter alone. 2:34 left to go. And the Patriots to kick it away again. Whistling back deep to receive. He's trying to gauge which way they're going to kick it. Going to go to him at about the 5. Looking for a hole. Dances to the left. He's got some room. Cuts inside a block. And one tackler to beat. Brett Poppy made the stop. If Poppy doesn't get him, Wissing has 6. But Poppy did get him, and the Eagles will start at their own 30-yard line. Excuse me. First down and 10. They spread it out this time as Ager comes wide to the right side, nearest us. Receiver each side of the field for Wissing. Option down the right side, and the handoff goes to the fullback end. Tell you, not much there for Tyler Schultz as he is buried by Jordan Ruger once again for the Patriots. Second and 9. 32-yard line. We'll call it second down at 8. Wissing with a pitch back to Harders. Harders trying to get outside. He's not going to do it. He is rolled up and dropped before he could ever get started by Alex Niederklein. Niederklein. Really, they've had only 1 first down tonight. That came on an 11-yard run by Jake Wissing, the quarterback. Wissing with a handoff to Harders again. Harders hits into the middle, and Ruger flattens him. He just pancaked him right there. And about the line of scrimmage, he'll pick 7-0. And St. Cecilia's on top of Gibbon now, 6-0. Those ball games near halftime. Better snap this time. Good kick away by Egger. Going to be taken on the run and on the dive by Evan Volsky at the 48-yard line, and that's where the Patriots will start. 28 seconds to go. They spread it out a little bit. Carlin with a single back behind him. First down. Handoff fake. Or the handoff goes right up the middle, excuse me. And not much doing on the first carry for James Nervig. Nervig got a yard out of the play. It'll be second down and 9, and the Patriots will not pull the trigger again. That's the last play of the first half. As the two clubs head off the field here at halftime, the Adams Central Patriots explode for 36 second quarter points, and they lead the Wood River Eagles here at intermission, 36-0. We'll be back and take a look at it for you in just a minute.
If you're looking for a position that pays more, then apply today at Tyson Fresh Meats in Lexington, Nebraska. Apply today because Tyson announces a new higher starting pay of $10 per hour, a base pay of $10.75, and the chance to earn even more with quick starts and extra grade pay on various positions throughout the plant. You'll also enjoy benefits with available health, dental, and vision insurance, paid holidays, paid vacations, and company match 401k. Tyson Fresh Meats in Lexington with a $10 per hour to start. Tyson is an equal opportunity affirmative action employer.
There are many things that bring us joy in life. Unfortunately,
campus here tonight. We invite you to stay tuned. We'll be back with four in just a moment. Tried to get working, and after that, they didn't kick it to him. They tried to kick it wide. At least if he was going to catch it, he was going to have to go left and right to do it. Wissing back at his own 5-yard line, and Drudick set to kick it away, and this third quarter is about to commence. Kick is there, and it's a bouncer down the middle of the field, and the Eagles will just fall on it, covered up. Ball was covered up by Shane Smith. And Wood River will take over at their own 27-yard line. See if the Eagles can get something started here in the third quarter. The Patriot defense, it has been stout. It has been stout all year long. They have not given up a touchdown in the last two ball games. So the last 10 quarters, the handoff right up the middle, and there is nothing there. Harders, the ball carrier, and Harders was rocked dead flat at the line of scrimmage by Jeremy Court. It will be second down and 10 yards to go. No gain for Harders. You're not going to run very much up the middle on these two defensive tackles, Ruger and Court. Wissing. Going to throw. Now he tucks it to run, and he's going to be thrown for a loss. Yep. Court was there again. Drudick was in on the play. Also there defensively, Forrest Weichman. But the loss is back inside of the 25-yard line. It's a loss of 3. So Wissing trying to make something happen, loses 3 yards, and it'll be third down and 13 yards to go. Now he operates out of the shotgun. They bring motion this side of the field toward us. Wissing rolls this way, looks this way. He's going to have to hurry, and he's going to be sacked. Court was right on top of him. Nervig was there, but Court just flattened it. So Wissing loses yardage back inside of the 20 to the 19-yard line. Lost 10 on the sack. First time tonight he's been sacked, but I tell you what, Jeremy Court, he dominated this series defensively, and Eggers will be back at the goal line to punt it away. The Patriots should come away with great field position again. Low snap, he scoops it up, he gets it in the air. Pretty good kick, but it's going to turn to the far side, take a backwards bounce, and be downed by the Eagles. So the Patriots will have the football at the 32-yard line. And once again, Patriot defense comes up big. Well, Adam Central has had great field position all night. They start with the ball at the 32 of Wood River. 2 minutes into this third quarter. Scott Carlin brings him up, and as he does, he sends Evan Volsky out wide this way. Weichmann flanks out wide to the right side. Two backs in the eye, a little pass down the line of scrimmage to Weichmann. Weichmann slips the first tackle and gets about 7 or 8 yards, hanging on to him. Keith Wetvik. In the defensive secondary now is Keith Wetvik, a sophomore, 150-pounder, and he just hung on until he rode him to the ground. It's a gain of 6. So second down and 4 for the Adams Central Patriots. And they take it right up over the right side again. Kevin Turway, and Turway blasts his way down to the 10-yard line. It'll be a gain of about 16, 17 yards for Turway. Well, Turway now in the ball game, over 100 yards. It is first down and goal at the 10-yard line. A 13-yard pickup for Turway, and they hand off to Turway again, and Turway takes it over the right side for another Adams Central score, this one coming from 10 yards out. So the Patriots kind of take the same page that they used in the second quarter here in the third, and they go 32 yards in a matter of 3 plays and less than a minute off the clock. Kevin Turway with a couple of runs, and then the pass play to Weichmann. 2-point conversion, and they try the right side again. Nervick, the ball carrier. Didn't quite get there. It came him out about a half a yard short, and so the score bounces down to 42-0 in favor of Adams Central. With 9 minutes and 14 seconds left to play here in the third quarter, we'll be back in just a moment.
Although time has passed since Hurricane Katrina's initial damage, tremendous devastation will remain. Hundreds of thousands of victims are now homeless and in need of shelter, food, and more. As they struggle to get their lives back together, you can help by donating at any Runza restaurant. Simply round up your purchase price and the difference will be donated to the American Red Cross. Join the Breeze 94.5 and Runza restaurants in our continuing efforts to help. Pitch in for those whose lives have been forever changed with Roundup for Katrina.
The Breeze 94.5.
Now the Patriots set to kick it away again. Wissing goes back to receive and field position. And tell you what, that drive, 3 plays, 46 seconds. They had a 2-play drive for 28 seconds, a 3-play drive for 16 seconds, and a 2-play drive for 14 seconds in that second quarter. And they start here with a 3-play drive in 46 seconds, and the lead balloons to 42-0. So the kick is away, and Wissing will get to test him. Takes it at the 5. Right up the middle of the 10 to the 15, tries to get wide to the right, cuts it back inside, and he'll go down right there. Yeah, Riley Arms again on the stop. Special teams tonight, he's been big. Sean Hatchell was also in on the play. He's been on a couple special teams plays tonight as well. But the return is out to... Ball is at about the 22-yard line. It'll be first down and 10. Wissing down the left side on the option. Handoff to his fullback, and nothing doing. He goes down in the arms of Adam Drudick. Big defensive end just slams him to the ground for a gain of about a half a yard. So Schultz ends up with maybe a half a yard on the play. Second down is still about 10 yards to go. Wissing rolls right, throws. It is incomplete, almost caught off the carom. It was intended for Keith Watobiak. Novick had it bounce off of him, and then there was another eagle in the area, nearly pulled it down, but it rattled around and goes to the turf, and it's incomplete. Stops the clock with 8:25 left to play and brings up third down and about 10 yards to go. And on third down and 10, they get two receivers, one each side of the field. Now Eggers in motion back to the far side as Wissing rolls to the left, gets a block, has time in the pocket. It is picked off by Mackenzie Hemge. Adam Central's Mackenzie Hemge picks it off at the 27-yard line. So Hemge with a second interception of the night for the Patriots. And Adam Central with their third turnover of the Eagles here this evening. And Adam Central will have it first down and 10 at the 27-yard line of Wood River. So again, they have it point blank. The handoff this time comes this way to the left side. They haven't run that very much tonight. Forrest Wakeman with the carry. Wakeman with the pickup of 5 yards down to just about the 19-yard line. So it will be second down and 5. Hand off to Niederklein. Niederklein swings it wide to the right, cuts it up the sideline, and a flag comes in as he goes out of bounds. Down around the 11. He was taken out of bounds on the far side by Tyler Schultz, the middle linebacker. Penalty of illegal block against the Patriots. So they talk it over with the defensive unit for Wood River, and they'll walk off the penalty. It'll come from the 15-yard line. Niederklein. With the penalty, takes the football back out. Only got about 5 yards on the carry. Penalty is a 10-yarder, so it's second down and about 10 yards to go, and the Patriots go quickly to the right side. Niederklein, this time hemmed in on the right side. Didn't get much out of that one. Bring it in and place it down at about the 22, maybe the 21-yard line, so he did pick up 4 or 5 yards on the carry. Niederklein with 116 yards on the night. 15 carries out of the Maryland eye this time on third down. Niederklein to call again. Left side, no hole. Comes wide to the left side. Looking to cut it up. Gets it down close to the first down marker, and I believe he's got it by the time they all unpile. They rode him to the ground, and he does have the first down and then some. Topic makes the stop, and the gain is down to the 11-yard line. So it's a pickup of 9 more for Alex Niederklein, and another first down for the Patriots. 6.5 minutes to play here in the third quarter. The Patriots, Evan Volsky brings the play in from the far sideline. Adam Central on top, 42-0. Knocking at the door again. They keep everybody in tight, go back to the Maryland I formation. Hand off to Kevin Turway. Turway, no hole. Inside, goes outside. He's gone. Touchdown, Kevin Turway. Turway from 11 yards out. Takes it home for his second touchdown of the second half. And for Turway, his fourth TD of the night. Well, the Patriots, after not scoring on their first two possessions of the first half, have scored on possession since. 2-point for conversion coming up out of the Maryland eye. Turway again, left side. He just burrows his way in. And he gets it in there. So that runs the score to 50-0 in favor of Adams Central. With the 2-point conversion, we'll take a break. We'll be back in just a moment.
It's been on all of your minds. That four-letter word.
No.
Chewed up a couple of minutes off of the clock, and they lead it 50-0. And Adam Central set to kick it away again. Their defense has been absolutely on top of their game here tonight. They have given up only one first down this evening. Wissing back deep to receive as Drudy gets set to kick it away. Drudy gets his toe into it. Wissing will gather it in at about the 5, maybe the 7. Out to the 10, 15, looking for a seam. He'll get it out across the 20 to the 22 or 23-yard line. And the Patriots were waiting on him right there. There were about 4 blue jerseys all over him when he got to that point. Well, the line of scrimmage will be the 22. It'll be first down and 10 for Wood River, and we'll see if Jake Wissing can get anything going. Wissing calls the play on first down. Little quick hitter to his fullback and a spin up over the right side. Gets it out across the 25. About the 26 or 27-yard line. Again, gang tackling on the part of the Patriots. It's a gain of 5 for Tyler Schultz. Second down and 5, they said receiver wide to the left side, brought out of the I formation. Option to the left side, and Schultz again in the ball carrier, and he has stood up and pushed back. He'll pick up a yard or two. That'll be about all. Linneman. Kevin Linneman on to the stop for the Patriots.
And on the
so it will be third down. It'll 3 yards to go for a first down as Schultz picks up a couple of more. Now third down call. Same formation. They split Mosher now wide to the left side. Keep two backs in the backfield for Wissing. Wissing back to throw. Coming up the right side. It is caught by Eggers. Out at the 35-yard line. And that'll be a gain of 7 yards and a first down. Zach Eger hauls it in. First down, the second first down of the ball game for the Eagles. So now they spread it out a little bit again, a little wider gaps across the line of scrimmage. Hand off goes to Harder as the Harder slants across the left side. He is eaten up over there by Forrest Wheatman along with Eberhardt. Andrew Eberhardt, the defensive end on the right side. Forrest Wheatman playing the linebacker spot on the outside on the right side. 2-yard pickup. So second down and 8. Eggers comes wide this way. He is the lone wide receiver in this formation for Jake Wissing. Wissing the option. He's going to keep it himself. He tries to reverse his field, and he will pick up a yard. That's going to be about all, as he is slammed to the ground on the far side by Riley Arm. Arm wrapped him up and threw him down. It'll be third down and 7 yards to go. Gain of a yard for Wissing. He wanted to bring it to the right side. I'm not sure. The play was blown up almost immediately by Jordan Ruger, the tackle on this side, as he penetrated it, and I think they wanted to go to the fullback, but Wissing kind of pulled it out and tried to make something out of nothing, and now he's going to be sacked again as blowing up the right side, Andrew Eberhardt, and Eberhardt sacks him back inside of the 30. Another sack for the Patriots. The football back inside is the 30 at the 28-yard line. The loss of about 8 yards on the sack. And now we've got flags coming out. Well, the Eagles lined up to punt it away, but before they could get the snap off, we've got flags coming from the left side, flags coming from the right side. That's a 5-yard walk-off against Wood River. Substitution penalty, and that's the first penalty of the ball game for the Wood River Eagles here tonight. Now that'll back them up a little bit, and for the Patriots, Volsky and Terway standing right at midfield. Terway on the far side, Volsky on the near side, nearest us. Good snap this time. The kick is high and angles to the far side of the field, and again, it will go out of bounds, and it will be in Wood River territory down around the 40-yard line. Well, they try to kick it away, and kick it away from the return people. And in doing so, kick it out of bounds. Well, Adams Central will take over, first down and 10, and they will start at their at the 41-yard line of Wood River. 2 minutes and 24 seconds left to play here in the third quarter for the Patriots as they come to the line of scrimmage. New quarterback in the ball game now, Justin Drudik, will operate the ball club here. Drudik with a deep handoff to the new tailback in the formation. And carrying the football right up the middle, Dustin Kerr. And Kerr scampers for yardage. Takes it down to the 35-yard line, a gain of 5 yards. So Justin Drudik, just a sophomore, makes the call. Handoff goes right side again. This time it's Ben Jones carrying the football. And Jones picks up a couple of 3 yards. It'll bring up third down and 4 yards to go as Jones, they give him one. Defensive tackle, Adam Johnson, combining on to the stop. Drudik out of the Maryland eye with the three-back stack behind him. Gives the handoff again across the right side. Carrying the football, Dustin Kerr once again. Kerr pops for a couple of three more. Stopped by the middle linebacker, Tyler Schultz. Not quite enough for a first down. As ball down to the 31-yard line. They say it was enough for a first down. Kerr picked up four, and it was enough to move the sticks. Well, it looked like it was back a little bit, but Drudik, handoff again, right up the middle. As they just grind yardage right up through the middle. Sam Curtis, the ball carrier this time, and Curtis, he squeezes out 3 or 4 yards. It will be second down and along 6 yards to go for a first down as Curtis picks up full. Final half minute coming up here in the third quarter. Drudik marks out the signals on second down. Gives it to the middle back out of the eye. Kevin Terway carrying it from, or check that, not Terway. It's Kevin Linneman who carried the football. And Linneman moves it down, brings up a third down and 2 or 3 yards to go. He picked up 3 yards on the carry. So that'll be the last play of the third quarter as the Patriots will flip the field here. After three, they lead it by a score of 50-0. Adams Central all over Wood River here tonight. We'll be back with a fourth and final period in a moment.
For over 150 years, Wells Fargo has helped our customers through all the stages of their lives.
The fourth quarter. Well, the Patriots out of the Maryland eye. The handoff to Kerr. Kerr right up the middle. He's got the first down and more as he takes it down close to the 15-yard line. Kerr will pick up about 8 yards, depending on where they spot the football. And Kerr moves the sticks. ball just outside the 15-yard line. And the Patriots, Justin Drudik at quarterback here in the last stages of the ball game. They go across the right side. They'll get a couple onto the play. Ben Jones, the ball carrier, and he is stopped by about five Wood River Eagles, but the charge was made by the linebackers, Tyler Schultz and Alex Egger. Gain of a yard for Jones. So second down and nine with the football inside the 15 now. Sam Curtis, the deep back in the eye, and Curtis gets the call. Curtis up over the right side, and I tell you what, they have just eaten up the left side of that defensive line. That's a five-yard gain for Sam Curtis. And that will bring up a third down and about 5 yards to go for a first down. So third down and 4.5 yards or so for the Patriots as they get it down just inside the 10-yard line. They come back with the Maryland I formation. Drudik with a handoff to Kerr. Kerr, no hole inside, bounces it outside and takes it down to the six before he stops. Keith Watovic makes the play. It'll be down in the area of the first down marker. And the officials are going to call a timeout. Yep. It was enough for a first down. It is first down and goal to go at the 5-yard line as Kerr added five more to his total. Drudik with the call, the handoff to Kerr again up into the middle. This time the Eagles are waiting on him and pushing back. Defensive charge was made by Adam Thompson, the defensive tackle, and he got a lot of help. But Thompson met him first, and then he got some help from Nathan Earl, who's into the ball game now. And a couple of other white jerseys were there. So no gain on the play that time. It'll be second down and goal from the six. 9.5 minutes to play. Hand off to the middle back this time. And carrying the football is Kevin Linneman. And Linneman finds his way to the goal line, and he's in there for the touchdown. 34. Linneman goes 6 yards for the score and another touchdown for the Adams Central Patriots as they balloon the number to 56. They'll line it up for a two-point conversion and see if they can add two more to their total. Out of the Maryland eye once again. Linneman again, the ball carrier. Linneman right up the middle. Did not get there this time as he's about a yard short. So 56-0 now our score in favor of the Patriots, and we'll be back with another Adams Central kickoff in just a moment.
It's never too late to get a great meal at the Barrel Bar. The Barrel Bar has their grill hot and ready until midnight Monday through Saturday to prepare your favorite dinners, like the Barrel Bar Charburger, grilled chicken sandwich, chili and cheese smothered stromers, halibut and tender steaks. Add a baked potato and you've got a great dinner. So before
clock and get set to kick it away here with 9:24 left to play in the ball game. Yep. Adam Drudik was a little late getting out to get the tee up, but he is there now. And back deep to receive is Keith Watovic. The Wissing not back to receive unless he is up, and we'll pick up the blockers in a minute. Going to come to the near side. It's going to be taken at the 25 and out across the 30 to the 35-yard line. The return. Sam Boschert on the return. Poppy was over there to make the play defensively for the Patriots, but the return was to the 35-yard line. So Wood River starting at their own 35-yard line, second-best field position they've had on the night here tonight. So as they come out, see if Jake Wissing can get anything going. Wissing, hand handoff on the right side. Harders hit right at the line of scrimmage, and they wrestle him to the ground. Riley Arms on the stop defensively, along with Nick Munger. Pickup of one for Harders, and it'll be second down and 9 yards to go. 9 minutes left to go in the football game. Flanker is Watobiak. He comes out wide to the left side nearest us. Back stay in the eye. As Wissing back to throw. Has time. Looks long down the left side. Intended for Watobiak. And it's out of bounds. Incomplete. And he threw into double coverage right there. Kerr was there defensively, along with Sean Hatchell. And they had that thing bracketed. And that's an incompleted pass. That stops the clock now with 8:37 left to go. And brings up a third down and 9 from the 37-yard line for the Wood River Eagles. Zach Eager brings the play in from the near sideline. And Eager and Boschert, along with Jeff Harders, all go wide to the right side. Double slot formation to the wide side of the field away from us. Wissing rolls right. He's going to run out of that formation and goes nowhere. Riley Arms again on to the stop. Riley Arms, 175-pound junior, and he has had a pretty solid ball game. It's fourth down, as Wissing didn't gain anything, and the punting unit comes on. Hatchell drops back deep to receive for the Patriots on the near side, and on the far side, like Sam Curtis, back to return the punt. Wissing will punt it away. He will get it away from about his own 30-yard line. Hangs it in the air. It's going to be Curtis who backs up to take it. Bobbled it, picks it up on the sideline, gets it back for a return of about 5 or 6 yards. He gathered it in at about the 22, got it back across the 25 out near the 30-yard line, depending on the stop on the far side of the field. It is first down and 10 for the Patriots. They'll start at their own 30-yard line. Or check that. They move it back inside to the 28.
29-yard line.
So the Patriots go first down and 10 with 7:42 left to play. And as they come to the line of scrimmage, they try the middle of the line once again. And tell you what, churning out a couple of tough yards that time. Was Kerr, Dustin Kerr, picked up 4 yards on the carry, and he had to carry defenders with him to do that. The hole was closed up the middle. He kind of slid to the right, and then that's when they ganged up on him. Second down and 6 yards to go. Justin Drudick with the Maryland I formation. They've kept it in. Littman right up the middle, and Littman has 3 or 4 more yards, gets it out to the 35-yard line before he is swarmed under by a flock of Eagles. Bottom of the pile, leading the charge, Wissing and Eggers. It'll be third down and 1 yard to go as Linneman picked up 5 on the carry. Just going right straight up the middle. 6.5 minutes to play. Patriots way out front here in the fourth quarter. Justin Drittick takes the call. Hand off deep to the last man standing in that Maryland eye. And Curtis, the ball carrier, is stuffed before he can get to the line of scrimmage. Blowing it up was Adam Thompson making the play defensively. Zach Eager. It'll be fourth down and 1 yard to go as Curtis came up empty. And on fourth down and 1, the Patriots will punt it away. So Adam Central with just their second punt, and it was nearly blocked. In fact, it was tipped. It's still a pretty good punt for Carlin, and rolls dead at the 35-yard line. Carlin had a defender right in his face that time. But he still got it away, even though it was tipped. And it turned out to be a pretty good punt because it ends up at the 35-yard line of Wood River.
5:53 left to go here in the final period of the ball game. The Patriots up by a score of 56-0. Wood River trying to salvage something out of this. Witomiak comes wide to the left side. He's the lone wide out. Hand off to the fullback, or fake to the fullback. Wissing keeps it, pitches to Harders. Harders, this time the option works well as Harders takes it for 10 out to the 45-yard line. Well, they made three good plays on that drive. The fake to the fullback, the ride the line, and Harders takes the pitch and picks up 10. Football at the 45-yard line, first down and 10 for the Wood River Eagles. Wissing down the line to the right side this time, goes to his fullback Schultz, and Schultz across midfield to the 49 of the Patriots. Just riding that right side. Into the play, Scott Schmidt defensively. Tyler Schultz was also there. A gain of 5 for Schultz on the play. So it is second down and 5 yards to go. Wissing with the call. Same play, left side of the line this time. The Patriots hang on. It's a gain of 3 or 4 more yards. Down at the bottom of the pile, Scott Schmidt had some help from Nick Munger, but Schmidt made the play initially, and then Munger came in and kind of cleaned it up. But it's a gain of another 5 yards and another first down for the Wood River Eagles as they take it down to the 44-yard line of the Patriots. 4:57 and counting as Wood River making the march here late in the fourth quarter. Wissing out of the eye. The pitch goes deep to the new tailback in this time, and it's another 4 or 5 yards inside the 40. Carrying the football this time is Bryce Baxter. Baxter carried it once in the first half and carries it here for the first time. Takes the football down inside the 40 for a gain of another 4 yards. So the Eagles starting to make something happen against the Patriots. Second unit here. Witomiak comes out wide to the left side. The lone wide receiver flanks out this way. The handoff to Baxter right up the middle. He's got another first down as he takes it inside to the 35 and down to the 33-yard line. A pickup of 7 more. And it's first down and 10 from the 34-yard line. Clock continues to move. This time they flip the receiver. The flanker goes out wide to the right side away from us. Option down the right side. Hand off to the fullback and Tyler Schultz just burrows his way down to the 25-yard line. Tyler Schultz with another sizable gain. It's a pickup of 8 yards for Schultz. It'll be second down and 2 yards to go. The Eagles right back to the line of scrimmage. Hand off to Baxter. Baxter right side. He's flipped as he crosses the line of scrimmage. He'll go down after a gain of about 1 yard. Linneman was on the stop. A couple of other blue jerseys in there as well. And they will send it forward for a first down. 2 yard gain, football at the 35-yard line now. 3.5 minutes to go. Or excuse me, the 23-yard line. This time they come left side. Wissing slips the tackle of the line of scrimmage, and Riley Arms wraps him up after about a 3 yard gain. Arms stops it. Check it, it's more like about an 8 yard gain on the play for Jake Wissing. So second down and a long 2. Football right near the 15-yard line. Wissing gives the football to Schultz, the fullback, and he cracks across the right side. He'll get it inside the 15. Pick up of about 1 yard. A lot of folks in on the play defensively. Stein was in there. Scott Schmidt was also in on the play defensively. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it will bring up a third down and 1 from the 14-yard line of the Patriots.
Wissing settles in under center. Jake Wissing makes the call. Fakes to his fullback, gives it to Baxter. Baxter's got the first down as he gets it down to the 10-yard line. Baxter gets it down maybe inside the 10 when they unpile it. Nope, they'll move it back out outside the 10. It's another first down, a gain of 3 for Baxter. They set the chains, and the Eagles can actually get a first down. It's first down at 10 from about the 10.5-yard line. 2 minutes left to play in the ball game. Wood River on the march here in the final minute. Wissing pitched deep to Baxter. Baxter spun behind the line of scrimmage, still gets forward. Maybe got a yard. He was wrapped up around the ankles by Justin Teal. It's a pickup of 1 for Baxter. And it will bring up second down and 9 with 1.5 minutes to play. Going out wide to the right side, Tyler McTavish. He's 5'3", 115 pounds. The numbers on his jerseys are bigger than he is. The handoff across the right side, though. And a pickup of a couple of yards for Schultz. Down close to the 7. Schmidt again on the tackle, and now we're down to the final minute. Patriots haven't given up a touchdown in the last 2 ball games. And now Wood River Eagles are going to take their timeout. Or check that. The Patriots are going to take the timeout. So with 54 seconds left, the Patriots trying to preserve the shutout here tonight. And the Eagles trying to end the shutout streak for Adams Central. The Eagles didn't score last week. Trying to get in the end zone here tonight. The handoff comes this side, Baxter. Baxter trying to get outside, and he is ridden to the ground at about the 7 or 8 yard line. Sean Hatchell was there to come up from the defensive secondary to ride him to the ground. It will be fourth down and goal. There was a gain on the play. Down to near the 5 yard line, a pickup of 3. But then the real estate ran out. So fourth down and goal to go for, or fourth down, excuse me, and about 5 yards to go for a first down for Jake Wissing and company. Staggered eye formation in the backfield for Wissing. He slides down the right side on the option, and he is dropped. I don't know if he wanted to run the option or wanted to pass, but Riley Arms ended it right there. Riley Arms throws him for a loss back at the 10-yard line, a loss of 5. And that will do it. This one comes to a close, and after 4 quarters here at Patriot Field tonight, the Adams Central Patriots preserve their homecoming with a 56-0 win. We'll be back in just a minute.
I've had a really bad day. My car exploded and left me with a broken leg. I called 911, but all the emergency vehicles were being dispatched to a fire, so I continued to drag myself home. As I got closer, the sirens got louder. Lo and behold, my house was on fire. A charred family sat crying on the curb. Honey, I said, I hope you took care of the insurance. When she told me we deal with Klein Insurance Agency, I jumped for joy and broke my other leg.
When you have a claim, Klein Insurance will take care of everything. See Klein Insurance Agency at 710 South Burlington in Hastings. Or call 463-1256. Hastings Orthopedics and Sports Medicine Specialists are committed to keeping their focus on you in everything they do. You can count on them to give you personal attention from your initial exam all the way through your follow-up care. They offer fair and total treatment you can afford. Hastings Orthopedics promises to thoroughly explore your options and help you understand all the possible solutions. Dr. Shingren, Bolin, and Noacek work together to ensure continuity and quality in your care. Available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Hastings Orthopedics, 606 North Minnesota.